Hey guys, it's Ty, and we just got done with AnthroCon, the biggest furry convention out there with over 17,000 attendees. And that got me thinking about all the conventions that I've been to in the past few years. Now I do want to say I've been lucky enough to have attended multiple different furry conventions, like FWA, AnthroCon, MFF, and others. But today I wanted to talk about my favorite convention and my least favorite convention. So let's go ahead and save the positive for the end and dive right into my least favorite furry convention that I've ever been to. That honor goes to a furry convention that only lasted 1 year in the city of Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. That's right, I'm talking about Capital City FurCon, or as I remember it, CCFC. I was an art vendor for CCFC. I was selling glasses and old art prints that I had from previous conventions. And I automatically knew something was off whenever I arrived. Most of the time when you arrive at a furry convention, you can feel the love and the fun in the air, but when I arrived, all I felt was dread. I couldn't explain it, but it wasn't until a couple hours later that my phone got a ping. I don't know the whole logistics behind it, but apparently the hotel contract was never paid and the deadline was coming up soon, and they were looking for almost $4,000 to finally pay it off, or else the entire convention would be kicked out. And I don't know about you, but I do not want to be left stranded in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. Luckily, two or three people, I can't remember who, purchased lifetime badges for the con. It did not work out well for those people. But they saved the convention. The rest of the con went okay-ish. I met a few of my friends there, sold some of my cups, and it was an alright con. But it wasn't until I was packing up my dealer spot that I heard rumors that next year wouldn't be happening. And I was kind of confused because it seemed like the con was saved and everything went according to plan. Boy, was I wrong. I didn't find out until after closing ceremonies had ended and everyone went back home that apparently rumors started spreading that the money that was collected during the charity showcase wasn't donated at all. Apparently, it had all ended up going missing. I don't know too much about what happened, and I'm pretty sure you can go online and look up CCFC FurryCon and find out for yourself. But yeah, saying the con was a little messed up would be an understatement. But let's go from the worst con story to my favorite con story. Now, I have a lot of good con stories, like the first time I ever hosted a panel, to being in a fursuit bowling competition, or even going to my first ever voice competition. But I've narrowed it down to two stories. I'm going to tell them both because they're awesome in their own rights. So the first one actually happened this year at a small con named LVFC, Las Vegas FurCon. I had just gotten done with my voice acting panel and went over to my friend Token's arcade panel where he was playing a dice game called High Rollers. I had just put in my name right before the last round started and I happened to get picked, only because someone wasn't there and they picked another one, and that was me. So the whole premise of the game is to roll the dice and try and get all the numbers off the board. And well, being in Las Vegas, you know I had to go for the big money. And wouldn't you know it, I won. I cannot believe I won. And it was a huge grand prize too, $100 Amazon gift card. And Tokens, if you're watching this, thank you again so much for hosting this game. It was awesome, and I can't wait to see you at another con. But I think my favorite con story actually has to go to FWA, Furry Weekend Atlanta 2023. But a little bit of backstory between me and FWA. So during my first ever FWA trip, they were playing a game called the QR code game. Basically, you would scan the QR codes and you would gain points on a leaderboard. For 2023, they updated it, more like an adventure slash Tamagotchi slash Neopets game, where you would send off your pet to explore areas in the game and they would come back showcasing new areas that they found. Also, throughout the con, there were secret codes that were hidden. This had me really interested in trying to figure out what all these codes meant. So when I saw a code, I took a picture, and little did I know this would help me out tremendously. Once I discovered all the secret locations and found all the secret codes and placed them into the game, I got a golden ticket. And that was the end of the game, but I had finished it in less than 1 day. So what did I do? I went around and I helped other people find their golden tickets. Little did I know that the golden ticket puts you into a raffle for a big FWA prize. And I guess the odds were in my favor because this little clip happened.
That's okay, we'll not fight that. And the first prize, with a gold membership, Artsy Filmer, our winner. Yeah!
That's right, I won the golden ticket, so to speak. I got first place and won a gold sponsor badge valued at $500 for FWA 2024. Which this year was really good, but with the increase of about 45% attendance, there was some growing pains. But I'm super excited for next year. But that wraps up the video. Did you like these con stories? If so, leave a like and comment your favorite con story down below. I would love to read them. Plus, leaving a like and comment really does help out this video. But it is time for me to move, so I better get going. But until next time, ta-ta for now.